than to have an endlessly changing horizon for each day to have a new and different sun. In this road, one such port is getting opened in Vellore district. Mother tongue, which makes us to express our need and desires, primarily is to be prayed for us to get the blessings of our Tamil Thai. Let's rise for Tamil Thai world.
Appreciation plays vital role I warmly welcome district collectors of Vellore, Ranipet and Tirupattur, Deputy Inspector General of Police Vellore, Superintendent of Police Vellore, Ranipet and Tirupattur. I feel it's not necessary to formally welcome our judicial officers and staffs since I consider them my family. Conversely, I am bound to welcome all of you with my open arm. It is honored to welcome the legal fraternity who speak for those who cannot speak for themselves. I welcome our President of Bar Association, Advocates Association, Women Bar Association Vellore, and President of Bar Association Arcadu, and all advocates in Vellore and Arcadu. I heartfully welcome Sumati Engineer PWD who plays major part of this ceremony. I happily welcome press, media and public. Once again, I wholeheartedly welcome all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Every system needs a structure to work on. Public Works Department has raised a new building for existing Arcadu District Council and Magistrate Court and Quarters. I invite the engineer Ayyarathas Rajashekar, Superintendent Engineer PWD, to present the project report.
Hello, the Honorable Chief Justice, Madras High Court, Honorable Judges, Madras High Court, dignitaries on the dais, dignitaries of the dais, ladies and gentlemen, good evening, welcome. It's a great pleasure indeed for me to present the project technical report of the newly constructed court building and quarters for District Municipal and Judicial Magistrate along with Cycle Stand and Garage at Arcadu in Ranipet District, and a newly formed special court for the District Judge for Trial Cases under the SCST Act in the second floor of the Combined Court Building at Sattvachari in Vellore to be inaugurated by the Honorable Chief Justice Madras High Court and Honorable Judges Madras High Court. The Government NGO MS number 874, Home Court 3 Department dated 22nd November 2017 have acquired administrative sanction for an amount of ₹427.92 lakhs for the construction of the court building and quarters for District Municipal Judicial Magistrate along with cycle stand and garage at Arcadu in Vellore District. The site for the construction of the District Municipal Judicial Magistrate Court Building and Quarters Building have been allotted in Survey Bill number 128/2/99/3 for a 1.4 acre land in Mukavathuvetti village, Arcadu Taluk. The District Municipal Judicial Magistrate Court Building have been constructed as per National Judicial Infrastructure Norms NJI with detailed plans drawn by the Chief Architect PWD. The building have been designed as a RCC frame structure with an isolated footing foundation designed for ground plus two floors ultimate for the office area and the ground floor plus one floor for courts or area. But presently it is constructed with ground floor for courts and ground floor plus one floor for courts office. The building area of the construction now done is the ground floor for the court. It is nearly 9,741 square feet, and the first floor, the court office, is 5,823 square feet. A total of 15,568 square feet in area. The judicial officers' quarters building has been designed as RCC frame structure with isolated footing foundation. It is designed ultimate for ground plus one floor, but presently it is constructed with ground floor only. The plenty area of the construction is 1,931 square feet. The garage is a 440 square foot garage is constructed, and a cycle stand for the court area 1,218 square feet is constructed. The facilities and provisions made in the court building in ground floor are District Municipal Court Hall 1,000 square feet one number along with judges chamber and public waiting area with a ceiling height of 4.93 meters, that is 16 feet. The court hall is constructed with a ceiling height of 3.3 meter by 7 feet with provisions of video conference hall, property room, mediation hall, dispensary, litigant public waiting room for male and female separately, post office extension counter, bank extension counter, etc. Provision for lift room, restroom for ladies and gents separately and for differently equipped person in each room. And the court building in first floor accommodates bar association hall, copies room, record room, computer room, staff lunch room, legal aid room, government pleader room, public prosecutor room, assistant public prosecutor room, etc. Restroom for ladies and gents separately and differently every person. The following special items of sorts have also been carried out. Tinku doors have been provided in the main entrance of the court and for the ASA judges entrance. Special type UPVC windows for the windows and ventilators have been provided. The courtyard furniture, T-court courtyard furniture have been provided for the courtyard and the judges' chamber. Rows of courtyard, corridor and other rooms are finished with double charge vitrified tiles. The portico, ramps and staircase are provided with cement concrete, hydraulically pressed and anti-slip designs. And the floors of the toilet, bathroom are finished with elegant, self-designed, joint-free rectified ceramic tiles. The property room and record rooms are finished with best quality quota stones. The inner walls of the court and, are finished with oil foam distemper and the outer walls are painted with exterior emulsion pipe. The water supply has a necessary water supply and sanitary arrangements are provided with a borewell of 120 mm and 3 hours for submersible pump as provided for water source. The irrigation arrangement with adequate lights and fans have been provided. The judicial officer's quarter, it consists of 2 members of bedroom with attached restroom, living room, dining, kitchen, puja, veranda, office room with attached toilet, all the special type of rolling and electric light and fanning arrangements are adequate have been provided. The construction work for the district Munsif come judicial magistrate court building was commenced on 4th May 2018 and the judicial quarters have been commenced on 7th March 2018 and it has been completed in time and now scheduled to be opened by the Honorable the Chief Justice and the Honorable Judges. The total expenditure incurred for the completion of the project is Rs. 426.92 lakhs, will be in the administrative sanction. In another High Court Registrar Record Number ROC dated 13-3-2020, they have allocated 12 lakhs for the formation of the special court in the second floor of the coming court building, Sadhwa Chai in Vellore District. That also has been renovated with in a second floor, 87.4 rooms, that is approximately 950 square feet, with furniture and electrical works have been done and completed. On this happy occasion of the inauguration of the newly constructed court building and special courts by the Honorable the Chief Justice and the High Court of Madras High Court and the Honorable High Court Judges, on behalf of the Public Works Department, the Superintendent, I extend my heartiest greetings and convey our sincere thanks to the Honorable the Chief Justice, Madras High Court and the Honorable Judges, Madras High Court, giving the opportunity to PWD and moral support to PWD for its continued services to the judiciary. Thank you, Nandri Vanakkam.
Thank you, sir. Now we are gathered here virtually for inauguration of special court for SC cases Velo and District Munsif from Judicial Magistrate Court building with quarters at Akka. Give action, do things, be sane, don't fritter away your time, create, active, take place wherever you are and be someone, get action. There is no further words to explain about who I am speaking. I humbly request Honorable Chief Justice, the Amrishwar Pratap Chaudhary, High Court of Madras, to enable the portrait for inauguration of special court for SC cases Velo and District Munsif Kam Judicial Magistrate Court building with quarters at Akka.
Thank you.
comes to those who dedicate everything to their passion in life. The road to success is not easy to navigate, but with hard work, drive and passion, it's possible to achieve dream. This is a lesson our subordinate judiciary is learning from our larger. I humbly request Honorable Justice Thiru R. M. T. Tikaraman, Judge, High Court of Madras, to address the gathering.
I am happy and glad that my Lord the Chief Justice has inaugurated the own building for the judicial quarters as well as the judicial magistrate and Musif at Arcot. It is my hometown, and the court at Arcot as a second class magistrate was originally inaugurated in the year 1977-78 by Lordship Justice S. Ratnavel Pandian J. And after nearly 40 years, the court was functioning in the Revenue Building when Lordship Justice R. Subraya was the Honorable Portfolio Judge for the Vellore District at the instance of myself and Justice Devachandran. The proposed papers for the construction of the Judicial Magistrate Municipal Court at Arcot in the own building was inaugurated by Lordship Justice Subraya J. And by the golden hands of my Lord Chief Justice, today the building for the Combined Court District Munsif and the Judicial Magistrate Arcot has come true after 40 years. And general public belong to the Arcot, I thank my Lord the Chief Justice for inaugurating the court building at Arcot. The Arcot has a historical background to Lordships, and everyone knows about the Robert Clive, whose success over the Nawab of Arcot has laid the foundation for the British rule. And in the video also Lordships have seen the delegate, that is the memorial, written memorial constructed by the Robert Clay. So far as the Vellore district is concerned, it is the one of the longest district after Dharwad district court in Karnataka. From the northern tip at the small hamlet in Arkonam till the southern tip in the Tirupur district, it spans about nearly 300 kilometers, while the exercise of sessions judge on those days it was very difficult, and now it has been bifurcated between North Arcot as Vellore district and Tirunelveli district. And initially during the British period, the district headquarters was functioning from Chetpat. After Vanwash War 3, the British has migrated the headquarters from the Chetpat to Vellore. Till such time, the Sessions Court at Vellore was functioning in Chitpur. This is one of the important things which I like to mention at this occasion. That is a state where the first Sessions Court came to be Vellore. Till such a time, the Sessions Judge and the District Court jurisdiction was vested with the Chitpur Court. And many of the people in the judiciary from the Vellore must be knowing. When the money suits, Samurai tribe suits, under chapter suits have been filed, if the plaintiff makes the oath before the Sakshi Vinayagar temple in Chittur, degree will be passed in the Chittur Municipal Court. That was a state where the Evidence Act was came into force, and people have faith on the promise on the deity of Chittur Sakshi Vinayagar temple, which is still there. This is the first instance where the session judge court from Chittur was moved over to Vellore. And during the first independence war, Sipahi Mutiny that has taken place inside the court, which your lordships have seen in the video, 176 cases have been filed against them, and all of them ended in conviction. And from the day the Sessions Court shifted from Chittur to Vellore, so many developments have taken place. Today is one of the landmark day where Your Worship has been gracious enough to inaugurate the special court for the 7th Suicide Prevention of Casualties Act at Velur. And as a man, as a person belonging to the Velur district, we are thankful to the worships for the such innovative steps to bring out the all the supports in the combined court building. And on behalf of the members of the bar from Arpad, also the general public, I am told there is a sufficient number of cases are pending before the combined court in Arpad, and hence the combined court district Munsif and judicial court will be bifurcated as a district Munsif and a separate court for judicial magistrate. And I make this representation on behalf of the bar plus as well as the general public for the Lordship's consideration. And with this, and thank for the opportunity given by the mayors to be a part of this function. I thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become character. Watch your character, it becomes your destiny. This is our Lordship. I humbly request Honorable Justice Dr. G. Jayachandran, Judge, High Court of Madras, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Chief. My Lord Chief Justice, my elder brother Justice Satyanarayanan, Justice S.M. Subramaniam, and Justice T.K. Raman, it's a very glad occasion for me and for my brother T.K. Raman as well as Senior Judge Mr. Satyanarayan, because myself and T.K. Raman are sons of the soil. The senior judge, Mr. Satyanarayan, is son-in-law of the soil. And a new building, court building of our own, makes a lot of difference in administration. As a PDJ, when I was working in Trulur, we shifted from a revenue building to our own building. I realized a lot of attitudinal change by the bar members. A sense of belonging always seen when we are functioning in our own building. And it also indicates the judicial institution is vibrant, still relevant. Because many times, many occasion, many events make us to doubt whether we are becoming redundant or irrelevant in the given situation. But whenever people crave for more courts, more judicial institutions, we are rest assured that we are very much relevant and more relevant than any other point of time. And today is one such indication, one such occasion to realize ourselves that we are all very, very relevant organs of the society, and we have been vested with more responsibility also. It's not that having a building for our own and all amenities has been elaborately spoken by the superintending engineer PWD, so how we are going to utilize this infrastructure, how this infrastructure is going to help the general public, how with all these amenities and infrastructure we are going to raise the reputation of this institution is more important. So at this juncture, I request my brother judges the PDJs of our Vellore district and other subordinate judges to ensure that all these facilities are utilized to the optimum level and help the public, general public, more particularly the poor. And this access to justice should not be mere symbolic, but should be very realistic. And we should also be very satisfied in the way which we function with all this infrastructure. And I see a lot of police officials, superintendent of police of both the district and bar members. I thank you all for the very good cooperation you have given for the judiciary to make this function great. And I hope that the infrastructure, what is now being provided to our district, will be more helpful for our general public. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, my lord. We assure my lord that we will be relevant and more relevant in discussing our duty.
Justice consists is not being neutral between right and wrong, but in finding out the right and upholding it. Wherever found against the wrong, find out what your goals are, figuring why we have not reached our goals, giving advice why we have not reached our goals, what are all the issues, what trick can we use to overcome the hurdles? We are manipulated by the strategies of His Lordship, Honorable Thiruvayam Satyanarayanan, Judge High Court of Madras, Portfolio Judge of Vellore District. I request His Lordship to address this gathering.
My Lord, Honorable Chief Justice, esteemed brothers, Honorable Principal District Executive, and other dignitaries present on the dais, members of the district commission, my dear members of the bar belonging to the government of the district, and other dignitaries present on the dais, as well as the virtual of the dais. Being the chairman of the British MP and also a portfolio in the Vellore district, I am extremely thankful to the government of Tamil Nadu for hearing the British proposals on time. Thank you, sir. Lot of buildings have come to me, and it is one more endeavor to give access to the justice and closer to the radius. I can only say that in almost all top headquarters there are courts. A lot of inaugurations have been done very recently, and by our honorable chief justice also expressing great keenness in seeing that the all of the city is coming to place to address the grievance of the region. To take a personal note, my father, Mr. Meena Sundaram, worked as a principal in the Vellore district in Vellore for 3 years. There I worked here as a high school teacher in Vellore. And I had my schooling, part of my schooling, in the Vellore High School in Vellore. And of course, my esteemed brother, Dr. Jesse Jackson, and points out, my wife is, my better half is aging from Vellore. I request the members of the board this opportunity to cooperate with the presiding officers to do more disposal of the cases. Though there is some difficulty in light of the present ongoing pandemic virus, I also pray to God to give good health, happiness to the members of the DC Ministry as well as the staff of the airport, to everybody, to tide over this crisis. I thank you once again for the opportunity given to me to address this officer.
Thank you, my lord. We are always obliged to extend our duties as per the guidelines of our portfolio judges. Thank you, my lords.
Human progress is neither automatic nor inevitable. Every step towards the goal of justice requires sacrifice, suffering, and struggle. The tireless exertion and passionate concern of dedicated individuals in your actions and habits, combined with intense effort and are directed by a solid purpose, it is the level of commitment that charges the senses and fuels your enthusiasm to attain the seemingly impossible. These words get reminded of when you all see His Lordship, Honorable Chief Justice, Sir Amreshwar Pratap Sahib, High Court of Madras. I request His Lordship to present His presidential address to this gathering.
Good evening, all of you. Brother Satyanarayana at Madurai, my esteemed colleagues, Brother Subramaniam and Brother Jayachandran, and Brother Tikaraman. I do not know, while describing the sons of the soil, why do we forget the daughters of the soil? I find the compeers who are announcing the program, they have spoken exceedingly in a very fluent manner, and at times I find that they were better than me. Congratulations, the entire public of Vellore, the subordinate judiciary, the members of the bar. You are all worthy of what you have got today. One of the Greek philosophers, Heraclitus, said, "Nothing is permanent but change." And change for the better. And change has to be brought about by effort and a collective effort. The collective effort of the government and of the judiciary. Action always speak louder than words. I thank the government for having helped us out in these COVID times in getting most of the buildings inaugurated. This is the need of the hour. And your state of Tamil Nadu is famous for its temples, ancient temples. And a large number of temples. I find now that it will be more famous for its temples of justice that are coming up so frequently. And I find the enthusiasm of the people, the legal fraternity, including members of the bar, being supported by the government in this endeavor to achieve the goal of justice. Vellore itself has been a historic town. But I think now with the inauguration of such courts, my judicial officers, including the principal district judge at Vellore, will commence history by giving the best of outputs with all the facilities that have been given to them. I have very high hopes. And I believe in them because during the pandemic, I have witnessed that all the members of the subordinate judiciary have acted like frontline workers. I think their contribution is far more than what was expected. Their performance has therefore strengthened the faith of the public at large. And this is the foundation of judicial system. It is faith on which our system exists. The new building with all its new facilities are just an opportunity to convert this adversarial situation we have been placed in into far better opportunities and facilities to the public at large. We cannot forget that it is the litigant's interest which is supreme. We are just tools in this system to enable the public to realize their cherished desire, which every man wants, the attainment of the highest virtue, which is the virtue of justice. This is what gives complete satisfaction to man when he gets his due. This is yet another milestone in the subordinate judiciary of Tamil Nadu, and I believe that many more such milestones will be covered in times to come. I thank all of you for having invited me to inaugurate the buildings today, and I once again thank the Honorable Portfolio Judges as well as Honorable Justice Jayachandran for having given me company, the Principal District Judge and all the officers at Vellore deserve all praise for what they have done. The district administration and the PWD department has excelled in its performance, and I take this opportunity to convey my thanks to the government for having given this day when we are inaugurating buildings for the good cause of the public. Thank you very much.
Thank you, my lord. We assure my lord, we the judges of wealth definitely will discharge our duty to the satisfaction of our honorable tribunal. Now I invite Chief Judicial Magistrate Velu to give a vote of thanks.
May it be so, Chief. Very good evening to all the delegates, martyrs, and doctors. I express my hearty and grateful thanks to my lord, Honorable Chief Justice High Court Madras, for accepting our invitation to preside over this function, and also thank for rendering the useful presidential address. I also express our sincere thanks to our Honorable Portfolio Judges of our district, Honorable Chief Justice M. Satya Narayan, Judge, High Court Madras, and Honorable Chief Justice S. M. Subramanian, Judge, High Court Madras, who are always great supportive for our development initiatives and spent a lot of time with us by giving valuable advice and for accepting to participate in this function. I also express our sincere thanks to our worships, Honorable Dr. Justice G. Jayachandran and Justice Kiru R.M.P. Tika Raman, Judges, High Court of Madras, who are the sons of Sahib, for accepting our invitation and for delivering their special address. I express my thanks to our Honorable Minister for Law and Courts and Honorable Minister for Commerce and Taxes and Honorable Minister for Labour and Employment for their valuable support. I also express my thanks to our Honorable Principal District Judge who made great efforts for organizing this function with great success in short span. Also express my thanks to the respected district collectors Vellore, Ranipet and Tirupathur, and the respected DIG of Police Vellore, the respected Superintendent of Police Vellore, Ranipet and Tirupathur for giving felicitation on this August gathering, and also thanks for their coordinations. I also express my sincere thanks to the Superintendent of Engineering of Public Works Department for making this function in a grand manner. Also, I express my sincere thanks to all the judicial officers of Vellore District for making this function a great success. I also extend my thanks to the President, members of Bar, Advocates, Women Advocates Association of Vellore and ARCOT, Court staff of our district, officials from various departments, police officials, press, media and public. I also get burned if I would have not mentioned anybody here. அனைவருக்கும் நீதி பால் அன்பின் கடந்த வேண்டும் என்பது வணக்கங்கள். வணக்கம்.
Thank you, sir.